Yes, good morning. The Thief's Story. A young boy makes friends with Anil. Anil trusts him completely and employs him. Does the boy betray his trust? So what is betray? Yes, what is the meaning of betray? Okay, when you break someone's trust, when you cheat someone. So who does I refer to in the story? Let's see. What is he a fairly successful hand at? What do you mean by a fairly successful hand at? Yes, Prabhu? Speak a bit louder. Okay. Anyone else? What do you think is the meaning of a fairly successful hand at? Huh? Professional? Somebody said professional? Okay. Okay. And you also make out some meaning and you see what exactly it means. So somebody who is experienced. Okay. Okay. So you see what, which meaning is better, is more suitable in the context. So what does he get from Anil in return for his work? So we'll see these answers from the text. I was still a thief when I met Anil. And though only 15, I was an experienced and fairly successful hand. Sit on you. So the narrator, we are to answer this question, who is I? Who does I refer to? So the I says that he says that he was still a thief until he met Anil, or when he met Anil. So at the age of 15, he was quite experienced and was a good hand at that thing. So what do you mean by a fairly successful hand at something? That he was quite expert in that. Okay, he was experienced, that is one thing, and he was very good in that. That is another thing, okay? So it's not about being experienced when you have a good hand at something. Yeah, with experience you get it. Okay, when you are expert or when you get skilled in something, so it means that when you have a fairly successful hand at something. Anil was watching a wrestling match when I approached him. He was about 25, a tall, thin fellow, and he looked easygoing. And he looked easygoing, kind, and simple enough for my purpose. I hadn't had much luck of late and thought I might be able to get into the young man's confidence. So what does it mean, Arpit? What does this paragraph mean? I'm repeating the paragraph, then somebody will be explaining it. Sit down. So Anil was watching a wrestling match when I approached him. He was about 25, a tall, lean fellow, and he looked easygoing, kind, and simple enough for my purpose. I hadn't had much luck of late, and I thought I might be able to get into the young man's confidence. So who will explain the meaning of this paragraph? Online students can also raise hand. Yes. He is a good man. From which? Okay. Yeah. You've been able to derive the right meaning, though the language was a little defective. So what it says that the narrator says that he approached Anil when he, at that time he was watching wrestling. He was a man of 25, tall and thin man, and he looked kind, generous, and simple. He looked kind, generous, and simple enough for my purpose. That's the main thing. So the narrator was a thief. So he was looking for a kind of person who should be simple, kind, and generous types with whom he would be able to manage stealing. Okay, the thieves or these kinds of people always try to come across the people, those who are simpletons, those whom they can be fooled very easily. And the people who are kind and generous, they are considered to be the ones whom one can be fooled very easily. It's the mentality of the thieves. They think like this, right? So he thought like he would be able to cheat him. He would be able to get his things done because he was a simple man, the one who was kind and simple, kind and generous, right? So I hadn't had much luck of late. What does it mean? I hadn't had much luck of late. He had not been lucky for a long time. So what luck is he talking about? He had not been successful in stealing. Yeah. For a long time, he had not been able to steal from anywhere. Okay? Because stealing, he was a thief. He was considering it as his profession. So as a thief, he had not been able to do his work for long. So if he had not been able to do anything, so he had not been lucky enough for a long time. And thought I might be able to get into the young man's confidence. What does it mean, Ruhani? Yeah, yes. He thought that he will be able to win his confidence very easily. Okay, when you are able to win somebody's confidence, what happens? That person even ignores your weaknesses. Okay? So that is what parents do. Because parents believe in you. Of course, parents love you a lot. You have been there with your parents right from the times of your inception. So they know you very well and you know them. But they don't know the kind of things the children are learning day by day. So the many a times, some people, you know, deceive their parents also. Okay, so and point is, I would just want to explain the meaning of this. Like, the point is that he thought like he would be able to get into the young man's confidence, means that he would be able to win his confidence. He will be able to win his confidence, means that the person will have faith on him very easily. You look a bit of a wrestler yourself, I said. A little flattery helps in making friends. So who will explain the meaning of this? Who is the speaker? You look a wrestler. You too look a wrestler. Who is the speaker? Narrator. That is a thief. Who is I in the story? Thief. Don't tell me narrator is I. Narrator, that's why he says I. So narrator is a thief. The thief employs flattery to win his confidence in the beginning. What's the best way to be friends with somebody? Flatter the person. And the people who are fools, they'll be easily flattered. Okay? Everybody doesn't get flattered. It's only the fools who get flattered. It's only the fool who expect the flattery. Okay, small kids, they are pampered by parents. Mera raja beta, hai na? My princess. Yeah, it's okay. Yeah, it's okay. Parents should love their children. Everybody should. But that is to some extent pampering. And parents should pamper their children. Yes. But not to that extent that the child doesn't see beyond that. Okay, not to the level that the child becomes that. Okay? So this is what the narrator is doing here. He's flattering Anil. He says, sir, even you look like a wrestler. And in the beginning, he told us, like, how does he look like? thin and tall. Thin. Are the wrestlers very thin? No. But he tells him, like, sir, you look like a wrestler. Okay, let's see what kind of person Anil is. So he says, a little flattery helps in making friends. That is true. But don't flatter the ones, those who are wise enough. They won't be taken into your words. Well, I said modestly, I do wrestle a bit. Well, I said modestly, I do wrestle a bit. What's your name? Hari Singh. So who is I? Hari Singh. Hari Singh, I lied. I took a new name every month. That kept me ahead of the police and my former employers. So why did he always keep on changing his name? Rabgun, yes. Okay, yes. So he would keep on changing his name to hide his identity. If he would not do this, then he would be very easily spotted by police or by the previous employers. So is Hari Singh his real name? No. After this introduction, Anil talked about the well-oiled wrestlers who were grunting, lifting, and throwing each other about. I didn't have much to say. Anil walked away. I followed casually. So Anil kept on talking about the well-oiled wrestlers, and the narrator says that he did not have much to say. And after some time, Anil went off, and the narrator followed him. Hello again, he said. I gave him my appealing smile. I gave him my most appealing smile. I want to work for you, I said. But I can't pay you. I thought that over for a minute. Perhaps I had misjudged my man. I asked, can you feed me? Can you cook? I can cook. I lied again. If you can cook, then maybe I can feed you. Got it? He took me to his room over the Jumna sweet shop and told me I could sleep on the balcony. But the meal I cooked that night must have been terrible because Anil gave it to a stray dog and told me to be off. But I just hung around, smiling in my most appealing way, and he couldn't help laughing. So on what condition did Anil hire him? Yeah, that he would cook for him. If he would cook for him, then he would give him some part of the food. And the kind of food he cooked for on the very first day, it was terrible. And Anil had to give it to the stray dogs. And he even told this man to go. But this man did not leave him. He kept hanging around him. And how could Anil be not strict with him? Because he had a way to tackle people. He had a way with everybody. He would smile. He would smile in a very fascinating way. That would make everybody befriend him or be with him forever. So Anil could not actually tell him to leave. Okay. So he took me. So later he patted me on the head and said, never mind. He would teach me to cook. He also taught me to write my name and said he would soon teach me to write whole sentences and to add numbers. I was grateful. I knew that once I could write like an educated man, there would be no limit to what I could achieve. So now this man, Anil, he got to realize that this man didn't know any cooking. He didn't know how to read and write. So he promised to teach him cooking. He promised to teach him numeracy. He promised to teach him write his name and all. So this is what this man wanted. He thought, like, if he would be educated, if he would learn how to read and write, then he would do anything, right? So later it was quite pleasant working for Anil. I made the tea in the morning and then would take my time buying the day's supplies. I made the tea in the morning and then would take my time buying the day's supplies, usually making a profit of about a rupee a day. I think he knew I made a little money this way, but he did not seem to mind. What does this line mean? I think he knew I made a little money, but he didn't seem to mind. What does it mean? Last boy. What does this line mean? I think he knew I made a little money. What does it mean? Why don't you stand up instantly? Now forget that you are at home. Repeat. In English, beta. Repeat. Okay. Yes. Next boy, sit down. Next boy, repeat the meaning of this line. The line is, I think he knew I made a little money. I think he knew that I made a little money this way. What does it mean? Tarundeep, you tell. Yes, that is correct. So this line simply means that when he went to buy the groceries and all, that Hari Singh, that is a thief, was able to make 1 rupee or more. He was able to save 1 rupee or something out of that purchasing, right? And he would keep it in his pocket. And he knew that Anil also knew that he was able to save some money out of the whole purchase. Anil knew this and Anil did not speak up about it. And narrator also knew this. Thief knows that his master knows that he is a thief. In the end, it means this. Thief also knows that his master knows that he is a thief. But even then, master is quiet and the thief knows that he knows, and even then, he's not speaking anything. So what does it simply mean? A kind of honest relation. He knows that he knows him. He knows that what he is. Both of them know each other. But even then, they are going on. It's being honest in the relationship. Okay, dishonesty is when one person doesn't know anything. Okay, here both of them know each other. Right? This thief knows that I have kept 1 rupee in my pocket. And even then, that person is not speaking anything to me. Sit down, you, Jayadatya. It was quite pleasant working for Anil. This I had done. Anil made money by fits and starts. He would borrow 1 week, lend the next. He kept worrying about his next check. But as soon as it arrived, he would go out and celebrate. It seems he wrote for magazines, a queer way to make a living. What is queer? Strange. So what is by fits and starts? With great difficulty. So this very Anil, you know, it's not that he was very rich. It's not that he was able to earn easy money. That's why he did not bother for 1 rupee. Each time, right? He didn't have much money. He was a writer. Okay, so whenever he would write for something, some magazine or something, then his check would come and then he would go and celebrate. But he was not able to get good, easy money. Okay? So one evening he came home with a small, yes, one thing. Why does the narrator say that it was a queer way to make a living? Why does narrator say that it was a queer way to make a living? So he wrote for magazines and he earned money, right? So the narrator says that it was a queer way of making money. What does it mean? But why does he say this? Is earning money through write-ups something very strange? The editors, the writers, they all get money because of what they write. Okay? The story writers, the lyricists, the composers, they all get money of what they write. Write-ups are so precious, right? You people all get marks because of what you write. So when you get something because of your write-ups, is this very strange? Then why does the narrator say this? Narrator was not very familiar with this kind of? Yes. So he was not familiar. He didn't know the importance of write-ups, education, and all. He was illiterate, and so far he had been able to make money only by stealing. Why did he opt to steal and earn money? Because that is what he might have thought, that that is the way to earn money. He might not ever have imagined that education can pay you so easily. Isn't it? You can earn so respectfully, easily. You just sit, write something, and you earn money so easy. So he found it very strange. Okay, education, what is the chapter coming about? What theme is coming up? Education, importance of education is coming up. Okay, those people, those who don't have it, they don't know how important, how valuable it is. But those who are able to get it very easily, you know, free, you have to just sit here under fans, ghar mein AC ke room, parantha saath mein aate the. Even then, children did not listen. Even then, they did not bother to learn. Because we are getting it without any struggle. But when you get it with struggle, the way this thief would be getting, then let's see what happens. I had been working for Anil for almost a month. So one paragraph. One evening, he came home with a small bundle of notes, saying he had just sold a book to a publisher. At night, I saw him tuck the money under the mattress. So one day he came home with a bundle of notes, and that money he kept under his mattresses at night. So from where did that money come? He had sold a book to a publisher. So what kind of book he might have sold to the publisher that he got a bundle of notes? What kind of books do you think? Kind, I mean, would had, huh? Hmm? Storybook means, no, I mean like, I am not asking you the genres of the book. I'm asking you like, from where he might have got that book? Yes, my question should be this. From where he might have got that book? It might have been his old book. Then, yes, he might have written it on his own. He might have written a book, maybe story book, poems, we don't know yet. He wrote a book and he gave it to the publisher, and when you write a book and your book gets published, then you get money out of it. Okay, so he got the money and he kept it under the mattresses. I had been working for Anil for almost a month, and apart from cheating on the shopping, had not done anything in my line of work. I had every opportunity for doing so. Anil had given me a key to the door and I could come and go as I pleased. He was the most trusting person I had ever met. So apart from taking 1 rupee or so during those purchases, this thief never ever, he never tried to cheat Anil. He could not rather. Why was he not able to cheat him? Despite the fact like he had all the opportunities to do this, he had the key of the house. He could come and go anytime. He could have taken money and he could have gone off at night also. But he did not do that. Why? Because Anil was the most trusting person. Anil was able to have faith in him, and that he could not break. Okay, so we'll continue tomorrow, children, this chapter. Thank you.